You to do. You are going to write three letters to yourself. You are going to write a letter to your 8-year-old self. So in doing that, I want you to think about what you were like at 8, all encompassing, what your world was like, what you were like, and then as your present self, who you are right now, I want you to write a letter to that 8-year-old about whatever. Just talk to them. Then I want you to write a letter to your 80-year-old self. Imagine what you'll be like at 80, okay? What you'll be like, what your life will look like, the things you will like to do. That's 2, right? 8-year-old, 80. And then the last letter, I want you to write to yourself right now. And I want you to write about what you want from this experience. What you think this experience is going to be like, where you're at, how you're feeling, how you think you'll feel. Anything that comes up.
How was the experience of Devise Theater different from traditional theater?
Okay, so Devise Theater is incredibly different from traditional theater. And honestly, Stephanie and Lindsay are trying, like I can tell they're trying so hard to tell those who don't really get it yet, like what it is, and oof.
I want you to start to think, where do I want the audience? It doesn't have to be traditionally in these seats. You can put the audience on the floor with you. You can put them in a corner. You can move your audience. So as we go through these exercises.
What?
We're splitting into 5 groups?
Don't know yet.
You don't know yet? Okay, interesting.
No idea. It all depends on the sites that they pick. It's site specific, so they're going to find locations around campus to present plays in.
So, like, where are these locations? Like, what was the criteria for selecting these locations?
They were going to create the criteria. But we have to actually be able to perform in them.
Okay.
So we need clearance from the school.
Right.
That's
a lot of people work. For like, the student wants to do a play on the roof.
Yeah, that's not, I don't know about that. The pool is an option.
Once you have your idea, it's organized chaos. So, Devise Theater, basically, you can get a group of people, but I feel like you can also do it yourself and get other people afterwards. But, you know, you get this idea like you would in a traditional theater, like an idea of something, like how the playwright has an idea. But then, it's like, I'm gonna make the play. So I'm gonna make this idea with other people and we're gonna write the script together. We're gonna design the set together. We're gonna, you know, do all the lights, all the costumes, all the acting, blah, blah, blah. Like, you can do all of it just yourself. I think I like it a little more than traditional theater because it's my artwork. You know, you can't change it because it's mine. I don't need to be reciting someone else's words that they wrote, you know, 500 years ago. I'm looking at you, Chekhov. No, I'm kidding. But, or Shakespeare. No, I feel like all of us are so incredibly creative. If we had to make one play all together, I think that would go really, really well, actually.
Together, together, everyone, together, together.
as long as Stephanie and Lindsay helped guide us through that, but yeah.
Who am I? Where am I? What am I doing? What do I need to do to get to my objective? Because those, the future scenes are abstract. They're not rooted in real reality, except the Olivia scene is a very clear character. But for the abstract pieces, they're harder. You have to create those characters. For all of you with your scene partner, look at your scene partner as the characters in which you're playing in the show. Now see your scene partner as the scene partner. And then you're looking at each other as the characters in the show.
I even did the auditions for the class. It was something that I've like never did before. That was my first audition and I was like completely nervous. I didn't know if I was gonna get in or not. But then they told me that I was gonna get in, so I was like, okay. Then we got an email like a week before class started up and it was like, the theme is gonna be LaGuardia. And I'm like, okay.
So you need to choose one character, which you kind of scored yesterday in the archive. Somebody you have picture of, like for example, the president or whatever, you choose one, right? So whatever teachers you guys took, like gather the information, choose one. And what you're gonna do, you're actually gonna place that character imaginatively in your sight.
My group is doing, like I said, the birth, which is also the past, and then utopia, which is the evolution. So where we had to see how this school has came from the ground up. So we learned that the school, before it was LaGuardia, was a factory, and there was the reason why the factory got shut down was because there was a big explosion and there was some casualties that happened. So they ended up having the building like designated for so long and there was nobody in here for so long. And they turned it into Community College number 9. That's what it started out as before LaGuardia.
Attention everyone, it's time for me to speak from the mind and give you all the scoop on Community College number 9. That was the name given to this place in 1968. I guess they thought we weren't gonna do that, great.
And we learned about the first 4 graduates of LaGuardia, and they were females. They were all people of, well, females of color.
I can't help the fact that the color of my skin is just a slightly different color than what's accepted. People walk around and talk about me. I hear dirty looks and comments about my people. I get dirty looks every time I'm walking down the street. I feel degraded, and life shouldn't be that way. But here, at LaGuardia, I feel that we as a whole and the rest like us can come together and prove to those who doubted us and told us that we couldn't do it, that we can do this.
Get up.
I feel like ever since taking this, I've gotten more in tune with myself and knowing what I'm comfortable with and what I'm not comfortable with.
Let's go back and lock it and figure out where it's going haywire.
Y'all want to see me get up without him?
No, Jason.
The actors are mostly coming up with everything, and you only have certain people who are in expertise of different fields. Like we have Steph, who's obviously a director, so she helps us with our blocking and placing and stuff like that. Lindsay, she's a playwright, but we gave her all of our material. We gave her all of our monologues, all of our scenes that we felt would go here and there, and then she just kind of like guided it into a nice format for us. We have even though we created our own set designs and stuff like that, we have Irina, who's a costume designer, who's helping us fit together our look instead of us all looking crazy and some of us in purple and some of us in like freaking tail or something.
What inspired you to help come up with the idea to make this show?
I'm very interested in site specific in general because that connects to the design right away, because the set and the space itself really requires the specific theme. So I wanted to go from something visual because this is what I do professionally. And when we talk about site specific is not only about the site, but also about people on the site. And I'm fascinated with LaGuardia and with the educational system here and with its mission. And so it was really a great way to connect the architecture with the LaGuardia itself, with the community. But again, I think the challenge was that overall to organize this very large amount of students. I mean, we're talking about 22 students in the past. I think overall what they did versus what we've imagined aligned with our expectations. We knew that the show will be connected to LaGuardia, but that it would also be very much connected to them as a part of LaGuardia and LaGuardia as a part of them. So I knew there would be a lot of personal stories.
I don't think about my future. I wonder all the time, where will I end up? Where will my career even start, or if I even make it in this world? I ask myself, what would I do if my plan doesn't work out? Or if it does work out, would it cause the people around me to get jealous and turn their backs on me? I'm consumed with worry. And to be honest, it's hard not to be scared when I feel like looking outside every day is a habit.
This is what gives it ethnicity and beauty, and that was very important for us to hear their voices together with the voices of the past, the present, and the future of this system.
Irina and friends pulled an actual tree off of the sidewalk outside of a real tree.
It's getting set up. So as long as the past is 30 minutes long, I think so this is present is five.
And so you're gonna find out on Saturday some the set ideas that you have created with, and Irina has also created, are really amazing.
We put a tree in there to symbolize birth and also to help with the idea of utopia, because that's my group's two themes. So birth, you know, symbolizes, of course, the life and giving of life and all that good stuff.
So we have to start implementing all of that on Saturday. So I want you to start from here on out, up on your feet and working on your scenes. So working, what I would like to do, I'm gonna start looking at on Saturday with each of your group is going to the space and deciding where, you know, we're gonna have to see where things are gonna fit scenically. And then we're gonna have to start thinking about where the scenes happen, like where is the brother scene, you know, Leek scene. Where is the president and Olivia scene? Like, how do we make sure those are clear?
What did I expect when I entered this class? I expected it to be chaotic, and that's exactly what it was. It was full of a lot of things happening at the same time, and a lot of learning and experimenting. I think it would help if we like picked a song to make a dance to. No, it's not everything, but it's definitely like helps. So if we're transitioning from your scene, is there a song that you have in mind?
From my scene?
The ending of your scene. Is there a song? Like a school song. Is there a song?
I know.
But we should
school.
But this is cheesy. Whatever. Take off these.
I thought we had to run some random maze.
I need a lot of speed, you know, so it's like.
Nah, yeah, this one has to be kind of fast paced. This is an Ellie thing. This is definitely an Ellie. This is an Ellie thing. No, because
Ellie, you're just like.
Because the way
and now this is like
artwork of it all.
You know. Oh, you are all. And I've come to realize that there were students here at LaGuardia before who I could have very easily have met yesterday with very similar stories or similar interests and things like that. So it's nice.
You see, can't go back to school if school won't accept me. And I tried every school.
No, you haven't.
I'm telling you, I have.
And I'm telling you, you haven't. You haven't tried LaGuardia, have you?
That new school? No, because...
Because I go there?
No, I just know they wouldn't accept me.
What do you do tomorrow?
What am I doing tomorrow?
Yep.
What I've been doing for months, baby brother. Sitting at home, watching TV, eating cereal, and doing nothing.
So nothing, great. Then you're coming with me to school tomorrow, and I'm going to help you get into LaGuardia. I know it's a new school, but I promise you it will help you when it seems like nothing else will.
With my performance, I hope that I can shed some light on a story that, despite it being in the past, it still is very relevant today. And it could happen today, tomorrow, yesterday, or, you know. So I just think I can spread some awareness and love.
Ula Rivera, 29, bartender, raised in the Bronx. He was killed by three skinheads. PS69 schoolyard, two blocks away from Elmer's Hospital where I was born.
I have grown as a performer because this class has taught me that it's okay to make mistakes and it's okay to try things. And that what better way to make mistakes than make it with an entire group together, because everyone in that moment then is really failing altogether and then not, because every failure just is like one step closer to what you want in a way, or what you end up liking. So it's really fun, it's really fun. I have loved working with my groupmates, I think, because I didn't get to pick them. And they are all so brilliant and amazing, and I've learned so much from each and every one of them. They're all so different. Every LaGuardia student is very, very different from one another, and I think we all just fed off from one another and created something great.
I'll update Lindsay about what we're working on. So I know some groups are like pretty set. I didn't get a chance to look at the presents, but I hear that you guys are doing really great and you have like a lot of set choreography things that you need to have happen, which is great.
I have grown as a performer, as someone who is incredibly versatile. So I'm not an actor, I'm a dancer. I don't know, my whole life I was just dancing. I wasn't really focusing on anything else. Like, I didn't really have any other priority except for dance. But then I came to community college and I was like, okay, this isn't easy for some people. You know, I thought community college was easy, you know, it's just gonna be easy 2 years. It's not gonna be easy at all. Some people have been here for like 3 years and I'm like, wait, what? Because of just the struggles they go through. And
I will understand that you struggle, that you need to survive, because you come daily in this smaller space for me, and I have to survive with you. So once you close that, like once I'm in the rec, then I have to survive.
My location for this play means that, like, Irina, who we've been working with, she said it was perfect because it was kind of like an arena. And we have those steps and we have like the front of Alipac. To me, it means just like the present. There's gonna be a protest. More funding. We need more funding for LaGuardia. Like, we've learned also some things about the past, like the student protest, how some of the students locked the teachers out, and how there was like some scandal with financial aid back then. Like, it just makes me realize how things have changed as well. LaGuardia was so much more different than it is now.
But I have my money. But I have my money. Break down.
LaGuardia itself, amazing professors, just like for a community college, like close to the city, like 15 minutes from the city, 15 minutes from my home in Queens, like there are endless opportunities and I want to bring that to my play, but also the struggles of everyday students, you know.
Wait, what? Thank you. I want to do this again, but here's the thing, is that what's really having the problem right now is the ending, you guys, is like, but this, it looks really messy. Is it two hands or one hand?
I thought it was one.
Guys, let's go in this direction. I don't know. I'll try to go inside and then outside.
Taking it all for us.
Looks sloppy if it's like, right? It just looks like you're not committed. So can you guys go into those positions and go there? Tomorrow night, remember that after you take your sights down and you get out of costume, you have to come back into the space. No one can leave. All right? Okay. Get home safe, get lots of rest, and we'll see you tomorrow.
Candy in the bottle.
What?
You know I forgot. Favorite candy from like months ago? What are we getting at?
Consider how the audience moves from one section to the next, how they move through to each site, so the transition through that. We put Jules his wraps at the end of each of your pieces.
This is LaGuardia, yeah. Let everybody bring it in for the story, yeah.
I think when I auditioned for this performance, like I did recite a rap, and now we're using that skill I used as part of our show.
But you can't be unskilled. You can't be unskilled playing an actor. I'm a student of the game. I need to know these things. But to switch and have change, my major should be everything. I want to just be more fair. I want us all to have care. I'm tired of there to be more because I want to prepare to be more.
There you go. We're a real special group just because like we're so diverse from like each other in so many ways that I feel like the other groups are.
I want to have the boys up in the car. See, here you go. You always want to try to analyze everything and make some type of connection. His flow is his flow. His rap is his rap.
I'm trying to figure it out. We gotta
I am you, you are me, we are we.
But we are not me. I am me, you are you.
And in a way, at first it was like, whoa, like so much like types of emotions going around.
If we make two, then I want you, 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 and you.
Me? But I think eventually, like almost right off the back, like we started to like use that to build who we are as like individuals and incorporate a real word such as ensemble, which is like all of us being together. as one. So how did you feel?
The man that you were trying to stand up for what you believe.
And what is that? What are you standing for?
What you stand up for, not me.
But what is that though? Like, what is when you stand up for something?
He gave me this request to write a rap talking about the first four graduates, and like writing that rap was like, I didn't want to just like BS it. Like, I really wanted to put the work in to like really capture their story of like what LaGuardia was.
Promises given on the way that we're headed, best out of 100. Cooperative education worth getting. The college so young, everyone still needs some funds. LaGuardia born 1971, full of daughters and sons. Four beautiful queens, grinding in Queens. A commendable start to give to their kin. Congratulations from President Shanker. Keen knowledge, naturally. Beautiful thinkers off to a fine start. Promise of fine things ahead.
Margaret, Lottie, Diane, Joyce.
First four grads to give our school
a voice.
Now follow me, Father Tom, to the past we rewind.
The interesting thing is like, I feel like the black box gives us a lot of space to like, you just, you know, mess around, and it's like, you know, it's a real space to perform in. So I think that's good. It gives people like that sense of like, this is still a play. But like for my character in the show, like I travel through all the spaces with the audience. So I think that's also cool that unfortunately for my, unlike my castmates, I get to really almost see the show myself and like how everything is, because it's just like, it's a loop, a circle full around.
So we have people tonight. Go back to the first day of rehearsal. Everybody, go back to your first day of rehearsal of coming into this room.
Theater isn't just one person. It's everyone. And, you know, you have your pros and cons, you have your arguments, you have your disagreeing, but you also have just something very, very beautiful and special, which makes theater great and makes this play great. So go watch it. Come watch us, The Loop.
And remember that very first day. We did not know what this was going to be. You met each other for the first time.
My perfect LaGuardia would be a place where everyone says hello, even when they don't know each other.
Like all of us put together as one, I feel I've definitely made more connections with the theater community. And some of them, it took a while to build up. Some of them, it just was already there from previous classes, like acting one or two, and other classes like script analysis and theater all. But they're all pretty well. We all work well together. We all know how to communicate with each other very well.
And you had no idea what this was going to become. And then throughout the semester, there's been so many times where it's been, what is this thing going to be?
Creating the show from scratch has showed me that any day, at any time, I can just get a notebook, pencil, start jotting some things down, and I can create something. I can just bring anyone along that wants to do something crazy with me and just make art, make something that matters.
How many times you guys were like, what's the lighting gonna be like? Where am I gonna stand? What am I gonna be doing? What am I gonna say? And I have to say that each one of you has a really beautiful moment in this show. That we managed that every single one of you is featured. It's really hard to devise with 22 to 25 people.
Impossible.
In the matter of 9 weeks.
And you guys have the chance for the next week and a half to perform and to tell your stories.
Please do have a great time and give that energy to everybody who came here. and paid $10 to see you all, right? So they need their money. Right? So let's give them that. Let's give them a $1,000 performance. How about that?
How are we supposed to imagine this utopian future without acknowledging our broken present? There's so much things going on in this world, man. Jules, you don't got nothing to say?
Yeah, bro.
We're gonna have some rough times, but it's gonna be a beautiful creation at the end. So,
I'm tired of dare to do more. I'm prepared to be more.
Prepare to be more!